This is the 15-round lightweight championship bout, and they're off and running. That's Vilomar Fernandez to the right of your screen. Young man from the Dominican Republic who now fights out of the Bronx and out of New York. 20 wins, 5 losses, only 5 knockouts. And Duran has 46 knockouts.
Tell you one thing, that Fernandez is going to have to be on those legs all night, and for 15 rounds, it's a difficult thing to do.
We're told that he's a classy little boxer. He does not have a big punch, and Roberto does. He'll walk right on in to get what he wants done.
Well, he's walked right on in and got it done for 9 consecutive knockouts, which is a record for any title holder.
Roberto Duran, that Jerry Quarry's talking about. Unflappable man. He just keeps coming. A better boxer than some people give him credit for being. He protects that chin pretty well.
He does a good job. You know, surprisingly enough, he can box when it's necessary. But so far, in most of his fights, it's not necessary. He goes out and tries to take the man out.
Looks like Fernandez is going side to side, and Roberto's trying to cut down the ring on him a little bit.
In all sincerity, Tommy, one of the greatest assets of fights, being able to move both ways. To your right or move to your left.
Pretty good right hand by Fernandez earlier, but boy, Roberto comes storming right back. Duran working in round one on young Vilomar Fernandez, and Fernandez realizes he's really got a tiger.
Well, he's going to have this all night. He knows that. But I think he's prepared for it.
Halfway through round number one. It's supposed to go 15. There have been a lot of jokes about it, not going maybe past 8.
With Duran, there's no question that any one shot he lands can get you out of there.
1 minute left in round one. And Roberto Duran is lethal. He gets in there to fight, to knock you out, and then it's over. But I'll tell you, he's been fighting all his life, down in Panama.
We didn't have time to show it, but when they had their instructions, he has a look in his eye that would put fear in me, and I'm a heavyweight.
His eyes are like laser beams. They go right through you. 30 seconds left in round number one. Young man from the Bronx. That's Fernandez, and he can box. He can stick and move, and that's what he's going to have to do to stay upright.
Well, he's doing a good job of it. He's moving pretty well. He's doing a good job of boxing in the middle.
Duran moving fast. Oh, he's got him in the neutral corner. End of round one coming up. Round number two, Duran coming out. His only loss in 56 fights to De Jesus, who is watching today. And he's after Fernandez, a 23-year-old that's trying to move at the 16-foot ring. Not much room, Jerry.
Well, I'll tell you what, with Duran, I'd like maybe a 24-foot ring. You need all the room you can get to get out of there.
He will hit you with anything he's got. He'll cross over and miss and hit you with a left hook. I'm talking about the champion, Roberto Duran. Fernandez can hit the body punch.
Right counter. Those work to the body. That's the best punch in the business. Ripping that body, and it takes a lot of strength out of your opponent.
And Duran has the stamina of a gazelle. He just keeps coming the same way through all 15 if necessary.
Well, to give you an idea of it, you know, he's had, Ray Lampkin knocked out in 14, Leoncio Ortiz in 15, Bizarro in 14. So he still has the power in the later round. But not to belittle Fernandez, he's doing a good job of moving and keeping himself in this fight.
He's a cute fighter. He knows when to tie up and when to move, and that would be about all the time. Duran came out of Panama City, and Ray Arcel took over and just made this young man not only to a champion, but somebody that really speaks for Panama.
He does that. He speaks for the legitimacy of the country.
Halfway through round two. Let's see if we can pick up a pretty good left hook there.
Good punches by Fernandez. He will have to continue doing that, moving and boxing and throwing flurries of punches and then tying his man up to win this fight.
The 10-point must system is in effect here. They have not waived the 3 knockdown rule.
Good right hand. Fernandez there. He's doing a good job of countering, Tom.
And the referee is Sergio Ley from Panama, which surprised me that a Panamanian would be a referee.
Left hook to the body by Duran there, and Fernandez missed by his own left hook.
Young Fernandez only has 5 knockouts, but he's got 20 wins. And this is the biggest moment, of course, of his life.
No question about that. To my knowledge, he only has one loss by KO, and that was to Ken Buchanan when he was lightweight champion of the world.
And that's the fellow that Duran beat to get this lightweight championship.
That's right.
A few seconds left in round 2 of 15 for the lightweight championship of the world. And the champion's on your right and still smoking. Live in round 3 of a championship fight. Duran's on your left, and young Fernandez is boxing beautifully.
Yeah,
he's backing into the corner.
Landed a beautiful left hook right there, too. I think Duran's a little upset with him. He wants to go out and get rid of this guy. He's moving, but he's moving good. And he's a great tactician of boxing. You can see that. He's moving, boxing, and throwing the punches at the right time.
Did Duran win the first 2 rounds or what?
There was no question in my mind. He won it. He put the pressure on it. He made the fight.
It's really funny. He had trouble now making the 135-pound class. He was 133 and a half, and some said he might have worked too hard getting down there. Duran, I'm speaking of.
I don't see anything that indicates that he's going to tire himself, but it is early. It's only the 3rd round. We'll find out later, maybe.
Young Fernandez, with his back to you, is a Charles Bronson fan. Maybe it includes Breakout. But he's in with a real fighter and a real boxer.
Them with the best of the business, in my opinion.
Used to be a street fighter, and they made it legitimate, putting right inside a 16-foot ring today, which is small.
It's extremely small, but Fernandez doing a good job of moving away.
I thought he could possibly win with speed of hands and speed of feet. We're halfway through round 3.
He got hit with a kind of a light left hook, but those punches take a toll over a period of time. We were told by Angelo Dundee that if Vilomar Fernandez got by 3 rounds, that he was going to have a good shot at winning this fight.
Fernandez landed a couple of shots, and Duran didn't act like he'd been touched. Steps in between them. Looked like Fernandez was trying to tell him he'd been hit low there. 1 minute left in round 3. Will it go 15? Woo! Fernandez got in, got out.
A lot of people believe it will go 15. But I guess I'm a regretful Duran rooter, because I don't think that many lightweights can go 15 with him now.
He can hit you on the arms or the wrist and almost paralyze him. Duran on your left, Fernandez on your right, and you'll now recognize him.
Those counter shots hurt. They hurt. And he's landing on the arms and landing them on the side. They do a lot of damage. Yep.
Fernandez moving in now, the closing seconds of round 3. And I think we got some kind of a fight going. Duran on your right, Fernandez on the left, and we've gone 3 rounds, and Fernandez is still moving and sticking.
But he's in great physical condition and knows he had to be and will have to be for the rest of this fight.
Remember that Barouette and Mamby went the distance with Duran, lost decisions, but they did go the distance by just moving and sticking.
Moving and boxing, that's it. You know, Roberto Duran's corner man is Ray Arcel, and he's one of the best in the business as a trainer. He's worked with Jimmy Braddock, Max Baer, Lou Nova, Graziano, and a bunch of notable champions. Just a super man to work with, a super trainer, as you can see what he's done with Roberto Duran.
And Roberto Duran does not mind working. He is a gym fighter, too. Not only does he show up for the big bout.
Oh, good right hand by Fernandez. I see a slight mark under Roberto Duran's right eye.
I saw those eyes looking over here, and if Lux could kill,
he would get rid of you.
Be in trouble. Was he hurt, Jerry?
I didn't see anything there that.
I think
in the legs or anything that indicated he was hurt.
Sometimes you just get his attention and turn him on, but Fernandez is boxing and fighting.
Doing a good job of it. He landed a beautiful right hand that it kind of teed Duran off.
Vilmar Fernandez.
You wonder in an exchange like that, at any time, Duran throws the right shot, he's going to get rid of this guy. But the guy is a tough one, and he's fighting with him. That's the mistake he's making right now. He can't continue to fight with him because he's going to get hit one of those shots.
He's got to get in, get out, and move laterally and not let that ring be cut out on him. And Duran is stalking him now. Look at the face on this. Look at the face on Roberto Duran.
Duran has a slight cut, very slight, under the right eye.
He's got Freddie Brown in his corner, one of the great cutmen in the business, too. Fernandez, by the way, is still a bachelor.
Good right hand by Fernandez. He's fighting a good fight.
And if his girlfriends are looking in back in the Bronx, he's in with some kind of a boxing champion. He's going to earn it today.
Duran smiled. He had the man back turned to him, and he could have hit him, but he played a good sport.
Good left hand by Fernandez. We're in round four, and the young man from the Bronx has not backed off too much.
Exchange left hook. Fernandez had the better of the two.
A good round for the challenger. Vilmar Fernandez is having a great round number four. But Roberto is still very much alive. We'll be back with more boxing action after this word from your local station. Jerry, the champion's on your left, but young Fernandez is hanging in there.
Oh, he landed a beautiful straight right hand right to the button of Duran. Didn't seem to affect Duran, but I gave him the round. I gave him the fourth round.
Okay, round number four. The champion with 46 knockouts is chasing a very hard to pin down young man. Round number five.
Beautiful left hook to the body by Fernandez. He's fighting a beautiful fight, but now can he do this for 15 rounds?
We have seen Duran knock out with the left hook. He's a right hand. Did that land, Jerry?
It didn't appear to land solid.
A lot of people love a young underdog, and he's a good-looking kid. He really is. 23-year-old. He's the world champion.
Not just a good-looking kid. He's a good fighter, Tom.
Angelo Dundee told us, didn't he? If it went past three, it would be a pretty frustrating time for Roberto.
That would be a good fight, and it is a good fight right now.
Each fighter under 135 pounds, which means you and I can relate to him.
Oh, a good right hand by Fernandez, but he got hit a good hook in back of it.
If you trade with Duran, though, you end up losing, don't you?
You can't trade. You just have to do what he's doing now. Boxing, throwing combinations, and getting out of there.
Round number five. It's set for 15 rounds. Think of that one. Right hand by Duran. Didn't quite get there. I'll tell you, Fernandez is cute.
He's doing a beautiful job of slipping the punches. They're just barely slipping, but he is slipping. By Duran.
He does that when he misses with the right sometimes, doesn't
right.
he?
That he does.
Tied up by Fernandez. A good time to do it.
Good hook to the body again by Duran.
1 minute left in round number five. Fernandez is bouncing and moving and looks smooth and poised right now.
He looks like he's in super condition, but he's going to have to be to go 15 rounds with this pace.
He said his favorite fighter was, quote, me. And then he smiled, though. He's a very polite young man. And he's in there with a real tiger.
And doing a good job.
Thirty seconds left in round five, and the crowd likes the underdog.
You see what he's doing? He's doing a beautiful job of moving back and forth to the left and to the right. And if you have that ability, you're a great fighter, believe me.
He's warned for not fighting. A little debate, a little controversy at the end of round five. Panamanian referee Servio Lay warned young Fernandez for not making it a contest. Was that right, Jerry?
Well, that was for what he felt, lack of action, and I have to disagree with him because the man is fighting the fight he has to fight.
Right hand by Duran. This is the start of round six and something big. Duran is hot.
He is. He's really teed off about the crowd booing the fact that the referee wanted the man to fight.
Clever little fighter, though. Vilmar Fernandez. Oh, a right hand by Duran, and he's after him.
That was a glancing blow. It didn't land solidly at all.
That's easy for you to say.
And that one was on the back of the head. Those are the kinds that do the damage.
Duran will hit you anywhere.
He'll hit you anywhere and hurt you, too.
What a competitor. And in fantastic shape. We're live from the Fighter Blue Hotel on Miami Beach, and it's hot and sultry in here.
Going to the job right now.
Round six, you can see the referee in there and perhaps hear him now. He's the Panamanian. Oh, Duran is a bruiser.
Oh, some wicked shots by both men. A right hand by Fernandez and a right uppercut by Duran.
Fernandez is...
Oh, a left hook by Duran, and he took it. On the button, and he's exchanging with us. He can't continue to do that. I guarantee you he won't.
Fernandez backing out the world champion halfway through round six. He is not afraid.
Not at all.
And that might cost him.
Got a couple good friends of mine here. Tommy, Chris Dundee, as everybody knows, and Bruce Trampler. They're watching the exciting fight right now.
1,400 people here live, and millions are watching Roberto Duran. Some people think pound for pound the best fighter in the world.
Well, I'm one of those that think just that. I tell you, those body shots he's given Fernandez, they're going to take their toll. It may take a few rounds, but I'll tell you, they are going to take the toll.
Today and tomorrow, right?
That's right.
Oh, we're in the last minute of round six, and Duran's after Fernandez again. Though seems to be pretty much in control. The legs are still good, and that's important.
Good right up here. He's only 23 years old, so he's a young guy with a lot of stamina, a lot of ability, and he's in there with a man that can bust his skull and is 25 years old.
Closing seconds of round seven. And Duran had to back out one time during this round. Fernandez is battling. Back in Florida for round number seven. Roberto Duran on your right, backed out a little bit by Fernandez, the young man from New York who's come a long way and wants to go home perhaps with a lightweight championship. 135 pounders. Oh, and they're right at each other.
Duran, he just comes out wanting to do the job every round. I'll tell you something, you know, everybody always likes to look at the heavyweights, Tommy. They always say that's where all the action is. But you look at the action you see here. He's a lightweight. The punches are coming faster and more often and with just as much power, as you can see by the way they throw here.
And with Duran, that means for 15 rounds if that's what's needed.
That's no question about that. And he's capable of doing it for 15 rounds.
Some people think he might be the greatest lightweight champion of all time. That has yet to be proven. There's no doubt about that. But he's a darn good one.
Oh, a right uppercut. That hurt Fernandez.
Fernandez on the bicycle now.
He's still exchanging. I don't understand that.
Duran is working to that body, and that is going to take its toll. But when?
We're going to find out.
the streets of Panama City.
I want you to know this has been as good a challenger as Duran has met since I've been covering him.
He just shook his head, Jerry, right in your direction.
He saw me and said no. Or I guess he did. There it is.
Halfway through round number seven, and Fernandez is still winking at those of us in press row.
This guy has got some ability, let me tell you.
But the other guy has lasting power. He'll be there.
I just talked to Angelo between rounds, and he said that Fernandez can definitely go 15 rounds, just like he's doing.
Title defense, and as Jerry Quarry said, 9 consecutive knockouts and title defenses, that's an unheard of thing in boxing.
Well, it's a record, and no question that Duran takes the extending at any time.
Duran looking for somewhere to go. Late in round 7, and Fernandez has not gone anywhere except moving around.
In all sincerity, I'm starting to see a change of Fernandez right now. People don't see, but I see some difference right now. He's fighting his heart out at this moment, but I saw a little change in his legs and some movement.
Action late in round 7. Fernandez on the left, Roberto Duran on your right, and Roberto is really after him now. We're live. Okay, my California heavyweight, how do you have it after 7 rounds?
Well, it's been an exciting fight, but I've got it 5 rounds for Duran, 1 round for Fernandez, and 1 even.
Do the odds change now? Do they suddenly shift toward the champion?
Well, they are always with the champion to start with. The only thing is, this man is fighting his heart out. The rounds are close, Tommy. The rounds are close, but because of his aggressiveness, Duran is winning the fight. And that's the only good right hand by
Fernandez. Stung Roberto Duran with the right hand.
And Duran acknowledged that. He shook his head and said, good shot, too. Fernandez
has 3.5 inches in reach, but that's only an inch something per, and it might not make a difference with Duran.
Every little edge helps, Tommy.
Popular. Oh, a good right hand by Fernandez.
On the side of the head. I'll tell you, this is as much action as anybody might want out of a fight. I don't care if it's heavyweights, lightweights, or what have you.
Roberto Duran just walking through the hotel lobby's excitement. He sort of scares you.
I told you that look in his eyes bothers me. Oh, a right hand to the back of the head again to Duran.
Looking into his corner, not for instructions, but just looking there. We're in round 8 of 15.
He is whipping shots in there, but then they don't seem to be landing solidly.
Fernandez is ranked number 4 in the world. Duran, of course, is all by himself at the top. Move side to side a little bit. He'll come out of that right hand with a good body hook with the left hand.
But he always seems to change his stance to throw that hook. If he had thrown that hook, that hurt. Fernandez would hurt with that right hand.
Fernandez is holding it now, but it landed.
He knows it landed, too. He's hanging on.
There's some redness now on the left cheekbone of Fernandez. The nose is red, too.
You can tell he's hurt. He's on the bicycle now. But doing a good job of it, Tom.
Good time to move away from Duran.
Good left hook to the body by Duran and countering right by Fernandez. He is in his fight to stay it on another right hand by Fernandez. He's watching. Dundee said that he watches the way Duran throws the right hand and comes back with a hook and that he was going to have Fernandez counter that.
Like action, stick around non-stop since they went out and got their instructions. Duran on your right, the champion, and Fernandez on the left.
Duran is throwing knockouts. five punches with every punch he throws.
Round number eight.
No power on anything, but there were quick punches that landed.
Duran is ahead on all cards at ringside. Remember, there are two judges on the 10-point bus, and the referee will vote on the outcome of this.
Punches and throws that left into the body.
We have seen Roberto Duran, though.
He got hit a good right hand.
Looks like Duran is going to go to work upstairs a little bit now. He went upstairs with that right hand.
He's starting to really rip some shots. We're going to find out about the intestinal fortitude of Villamar Fernandez this round. Oh, ripping shots to the body. Those hurt.
What would be the best way to fight Roberto Duran? I mean, other than not signing the contract.
With a friend.
He's got to keep moving. He's slowing down a lot.
Those body punches are doing their damage now. Oh, ripping shots. But he's hurting him now.
Duran scoring almost at will now. Over in Fernandez's corner.
Low blow by Duran with a low kick. The man's coming back, though. Duran doesn't believe in himself.
When you're hurt, you got to throw punches. Fernandez is.
That's what you have to do. This is a great fight, Tom. A good round, and he's coming back. Oh! Wicked shot by both men.
And Duran had to hold on.
He doesn't believe what this guy's made of.
The crowd loves it here. And I hope you do. You see, there's the Duran on the move again.
I know that he had to be hurt over in that corner, and he's coming back like nothing happened.
A nice round of a 15-round lightweight championship bout. We're live.
And I just got a look from Villamar Fernandez. Said, no, this guy's not hurting me. Just gave me a wink out of the eye, you know.
One thing about Roberto Duran, if you fight him, you have to fight, because he's always right there on your press plate.
No question about that, Tommy. He can do it.
Less than 30 left in round nine.
This man he's with can do it too, though.
What kind of condition is the challenge here? That's what we're going to find out. Round number nine, and Fernandez has held his own after a bad rocket start in this round. End of round nine. CBS. On his right, the president of the CBS Broadcasting Group, Blackjack Snyder. I wonder what they think about the first nine.
Well, they got to be happy with it. Especially if they're involved in the production of this show.
How do you have it? Is Duran completely in control?
I've got Duran dominating the fight, but he's got a tough competitor in there with him.
I'll tell you one thing, he can dance. He can dance. Fernandez has moved and stuck and punched better than I thought he could punch.
And fought. Fought like heck.
Oh,
they switched, and a better shot was landed by Fernandez. A beautiful left hook. And he started to throw another hook, and his arm got caught by the rope over there.
Right hand by Duran got through. Let's see how the left eye and cheekbone look. He's still all right.
Doesn't appear to be any some redness around the left eye.
Fernandez has Miranda in his corner, also a veteran.
Oh, a beautiful right hand by Fernandez. Landed right on a button, but he obviously is not a powerful puncher. That should have done some damage.
Look how his back is lacerated, where Duran just keeps coming and hits anything that stops.
Pushes him on those ropes. He's got a red back and blue from the ropes. Instead of black and blue, he's blue and red.
Fernandez with his back to you, and Roberto Duran just stalking, looking, banging, trying anything really. Halfway through round number 10.
Oh, good right hand. That hurt. I saw the knees of Fernandez buckle for the first time in the fight. He is hurt. There's no question in my mind.
The challenger is
question about, but he's doing a good job of tying him up. He's a pro. Look at his leg. His legs are wobbling.
One minute left in round 10.
Duran is kind of punching himself out. He knows the man's hurt. He can't follow it up.
Duran has got him in his own corner. Fernandez is going to quit and sit down on the stool there if he can make it through.
You know he's going to do his job. He's, look at him. Now he's back punching again. Oh, there he went to legs again.
35 seconds left. It seems like an hour if you're Fernandez right now. Oh, in the left hand.
Wicked shot, fighter. I don't believe it.
Holding on. Leg gets in between them.
He just looked at me and said nothing. And count a beautiful right hand by Fernandez.
15 seconds left. Both fighters are holding and breathing hard and still swinging. We'll be back with more boxing action after this word from your local station. Hang tough. Up and Roberto Duran has found that Fernandez is equal to darn near anything he can swing so far. There's the champion. That's Arcel talking to him.
This has been as exciting a fight as I have seen in quite some time.
Here he is, and he looks all right. He's moving again. How are the legs, Jerry?
They look good. They look good. They were buckled a few times the last round, but he's back doing his thing again.
Man, back doing his thing.
And his thing is breaking hips.
Athlete. There, a right hand by Roberto Duran.
That was blocked by the glove, Tommy, so it didn't do any damage to Fernandez.
And still moving. Fernandez in a lot of trouble in round 10, but he looks all right again.
He's back on his bicycle and doing a great job.
He has countered well. He has punched harder than people thought he could, including Roberto Duran.
He has taken some shots that Duran did not believe he could take. And I'm surprised by it, too.
A bachelor fighting out of the Bronx to the left. And that's Duran right on top of him.
Another right hand. I think that was partially blocked by the glove, but part of it got through. I don't think Duran believes what this man has taken. Oh, he switched again and threw that left hook to the body.
Before the legs slow up. Is it the last minute of each round now? That's what we're going to be watching.
Oh, good exchange. A lift. Lift took the right hand by Duran. Fernandez looked at me again and still said no.
He said he thought he could win with hand speed. But halfway through round 11, he's really winning with guts. He's really boxing.
We're starting to question his legs and his stamina. Let's start to question some of Duran's. Can he keep it up?
But getting to 133 and a half was a problem this time.
Still throwing powerful punches, though.
He's beaten some of the great fighters. Kenny Buchanan.
I just saw a look of hate in Roberto Duran's eyes.
That's the way it should be. 1 minute left. Round 11. Duran has slowed the pace a little bit.
Well, hey, after that 10th round, what can you ask for?
Tricycle time. Keep on it.
I got news for you. I'd be on a motorcycle if I were in the ring with this guy.
Duran still looks like he's bushy tails. Roberto Duran is still the man in charge. Seconds of round 11, live from Miami Beach. We'll return to Miami Beach in just a moment, but right now, let's go to Vince Scully for a report on the Andy Williams San Diego Open Golf Tournament. In boxing, I'll get you knocked out. We've got a doozy here, the 12th round of 15, Duran on your right, the champion, and Fernandez just won't quit.
Well, let me tell you something, any backswing in boxing will get you knocked out.
Roberto, not as fresh looking as he was. And I thought Fernandez on his stool looked like he was pretty fresh.
Yeah, he was ready to come out for some more action.
But Roberto Duran is the champion, and he is a fighting champion. He doesn't care if it takes 36 rounds. He only has 15 to work in, but he's always there and always, always. always in progress.
He has landed some solid shots, and there's only been a couple that have hurt Fernandez.
Fernandez caught his way out and held on again.
He's fighting a beautiful fight. I'm proud to say that I'm announcing this fight with you, Tom, because it's a beautiful fight.
To see 235 pounders or so do a job. You don't have to be 220 to be a great athlete and have it going.
There's more action in this fight than you see in any heavyweight bout.
Duran now picking his shots a little bit.
This is the 12th round. Let's face it, they've gone through some wild action, and they both have to be in superior condition.
Way since the opening bell, and we're in the 12th round, and Fernandez, the young man you see right there, has done everything but disappear, but he's always there.
One thing about the Panamanian referee cannot say now, hey, come on, let's step up the action.
Round 12, less than halfway.
Left hook to the body. I think that did some damage.
Has attended George Washington High School in the Bronx, where a lot of great athletes have come from.
Great. The left hook that was very, very low.
He counted as a knockdown.
It was a low blow. No question about it, it was a low blow. And he returned the favor. He went right back.
And boxing talent, and Duran must be getting tired from throwing all the leather.
I'm getting tired from watching all the leather.
30 seconds left in round 12. Can you believe it? Low blow, counted as a knockdown. We'll talk about that.
I really wonder if there was a knockdown, there would have been a mandatory 8 count, so I don't think they called it. A left hook to the body and to the chin by Duran that did some damage.
Storm is Fernandez, and Duran is still laying it on. Round number 12 coming to a close. And here comes the champion. He's up off Marcel Stewart in a hurry.
I don't think Fernandez can win this fight, but he showed me an awful lot of courage tonight, and somebody's got to give him some credit for that.
One thing, when he flies back into JFK, there'll be a lot of people there just to take a look at him. He's something else.
He is some fighter. Oh, and he lands a good right hand.
Tried to fight his way out of trouble.
That's the wrong thing to do, Dre. I don't care. He's taking some wicked shots and everything, but you don't do it with a man that has 46 knockouts.
Especially one with a chin like concrete.
Right.
De Jesus knocked him down in the first round, and in the 11th round, he counted De Jesus out. You know, he is a sticker, a keeper, as they say.
In fact, you know, the only two times he's been down in his career were both by De Jesus. In the first round of both their fights.
De Jesus and Roberto Duran, that's further down the pike, but that's going to be here on CBS, too. Champion, only one loss in 56 professional fights.
You see the pace has slowed down, and that's because of the excitement of the earlier phase. I mean, it's just too much to ask of an athlete to give himself a 15 rounds to 3 minutes of every round.
By the way, De Jesus will be on CBS on the 12th from San Juan, so we'll take a look at him in 2 weeks. I'll tell you one thing, the lightweights can go 15. They haven't stopped.
So they have been doing it.
Halfway through round 13. And Fernandez looks much like he did in the third or fourth round. And he's taking some.
A wicked attack to the body that hurt Fernandez. No question. That was a left hook in the liver. That's one of the toughest shots to take in boxing.
Durant's in the neutral corner. They're counting.
He's out. He's not going to get up.
It's over. A kidney shot by Roberto Duran.
Shot a left hook to the liver.
All right. Let's take a look at this shot right now. Duran in the first feet, lining him up.
Left hook to the liver, and that's the most wicked shot thrown in boxing, and it did its damage.
And he followed with a right hand under the heart. Jerry Quarry, you're going to be up in the ring talking to the champion. Find out how he felt, and we'd like to know how he feels about the young man you're watching go down right here, Vilomar Fernandez, a valiant challenger and a super boxer.
You've got that.
All right, we'll be back to talk to Roberto Duran, the lightweight champion of the world, in just a moment. It was some fight, wasn't it?
Your hardest fight against an extremely talented challenger.
He said the fellow wasn't that strong to him. He was very smart in the ring. He knows how to move. And it was just only time for him to get to him until eventually he got to him.
Let me ask you, Roberto, what did you feel about some of the shots that you landed? You landed some extremely hard shots, and he took a lot of them. But you finally got him with a left hook to the liver.
Bueno, que yo todavía no me había sentido la mano, pues estaba todavía un poco frío y me estaba calentando apenas. Cuando ya cayó a la altura del octavo, fue que yo comencé a sentir la mano pesada. Yo digo, ahora es que voy a tirar los golpes con más fuerza, que él se va a tener que caer con algún gancho abajo. He said that when the fight started, he was very cold and he hit some good punches, but it wasn't his best punches. When the eighth round was over, that's when he really felt strong and he started to look for the knockout.
What? Can we take a look at this? Here, we're going to take a look at it, Roberto.
This two up over
here,
the body.
Yeah. How did you feel? It was a left hook to the liver.
Okay.
This two up. He said that the body punches that he gave him were taking effect. And he knew that in this round or the following round, he would have had him.
Well, I'd like to say, Roberto, congratulations.
Thank you.
You did a super job.
Thank you, thank you. You know, me not too much stop, but no job too much for a midi rest. The punch got too much job, this is the time for me. Me take it easy, take it easy, move, me knock him out.
There you go.
Congratulations to you. Here you are, Tommy, and we'll give it back to you.